Hello, my friends, and welcome to another episode of the Million Pound Mission Podcast. It's your buddy Adam, the PhD, the previously heavy dude, and this is episode number 330, Adjusting to Quarantine Life. Obviously, things are a little bit out of the ordinary in the world right now with the coronavirus pandemic, and in case you're wondering, like, oh, where you been, Adam? Where you been on this topic? I record my shows about a month in advance, so I'm actually recording this mid-March, and this is coming out on April 6th, so I'm sure things will have changed by then, hopefully for the better. Right now, you know, the whole self-distancing thing is happening, the quarantining is happening, the stay-at-home movement is happening, and we are a part of that here in my house. And, you know, I feel like this is an important topic to talk about because the concepts we're going to talk about today can be applied in a lot of different situations, but it's especially applicable to what we're dealing with right now. And before we dive into it, I just want to give you a heads up on where the community is at. The Mission Possible community is really ramped up. People need this right now. Like, you need community, you need interaction. And I've been providing this for years and years and years, and now it's especially important with everything that's happening in the world. So I'll give you a heads up on what's happening inside the community. This week, we are starting a brand new 28-day cycle. We have those battle plan workbooks mapped out. Our cheat banks are built. We are ready to rock starting today. Today is day one of a brand new 28-day cycle. And inside of our Facebook group, we're going to do an accountability sprint week where everybody, myself included, will be posting their food and fitness for the day. Just a quick check-in to kind of ramp up our accountability. I will assign accountability buddies, the accountability partners for the rest of the 28-day cycle as well this week. So, you know, week one is always a lot of fun. We've also got a group Zoom community chat, a video chat tomorrow. That will be April 7th at 7 p.m. Eastern. That's Tuesday, April 7th. That is going on. Week three, we're going to do a minimalism challenge. This is a fan favorite where we're going to declutter. And basically what we'll do is, you know, 7 days, week three. Day one, you will declutter and donate one item. Day two, you will donate two items. Day three, three items. And we usually have like a donation box, depending on what's open and what's not open, especially right now. But it's really cool because on day seven, you're donating seven items and you will have decluttered. I usually tell people to focus on one area of their home and really pick one item out of that area. Day one, two items for day two, three items for day three. And you will declutter an area. Last time I did this, I did my workspace, my desk, and it was amazing. I think I will dig into the garage for this next round. I don't have a whole lot of clutter, being a minimalist, and like I own less than 80 articles of clothing. Socks count as two. At any point in time, any day, I'm wearing 10% of my total wardrobe on my body. Think about that for a second. For those of you that have lots and lots, most people have more shoes than I have clothes. Let's just put it that way. So a lot of times people in my videos are like, why are you always wearing the same shirt? I'm like, I have a few shirts, a lot of black shirts that have the Million Pound Mission brand on them and some sweatshirts and a couple pairs of sweatpants and one or two pairs of shorts. And I'm kind of good. The minimalism challenge will be a lot of fun. That happens week three. And then week four, we do hot seats, the one-on-one 15-minute coaching sessions that you hear on Fridays. On that note also, just with everything that is happening, with the coronavirus, the change in the schedule, like my kids are at home, I'm in charge of their online education. It's a time consuming thing. So right now the plan is, I've got all of the Friday episodes already pre-booked through April. I may cut back in May to just one episode a week, just the Monday episode, and drop the Fridays for the time being until I can kind of get my schedule sorted out and, you know, we're all adjusting. So that's kind of what this whole episode is about. So let's go ahead and dive into adjusting to quarantine life. And I want to kick it off with one of my favorite things that I've put out there in the podcast before. And it is the quote of, when we can't be at our best, we can still do our best. I think this is just so applicable for what we're all dealing with right now. And I know a lot of you run a health journey that had some positive momentum going behind it. And all of a sudden, gyms shut down. Can't go to personal training. Can't go to boot camp. Can't go to your gym and do your strength training. Can't get that cardio in. You know, the restaurants are closing. which I'll get to later, but probably isn't that necessarily a really bad thing for people on a weight loss journey, but we're out of our comfort zone. It is a complete, you know, just lifestyle shift that's happening. We're staying at home. We are isolated from community members. And with a lot of that comes the support and the accountability anchor points that we're used to. So I want to run you through a process, just a series of questions that we need to think through where, just to get our mind right, to realize that, okay, this isn't perfect. This isn't ideal, but you know, we're not necessarily at our best right now. We're not optimized, but we can still do our best each day. We don't have to just sit and feel sorry for ourselves and sit and eat and sit and mope and get depressed. Like, we can still take action with what we've got. All right. So here are a few questions to think about and work through, just to make sure, like, what I don't want happening is I don't want you guys to put your health on hold until, you know, quote unquote, normal happens again. Like, oh, I'll get back to everything once the world gets back to being normal. And until then, it's day drinking and cupcakes and Netflix. We all might have a day like that, but let's just isolate it to one day. All right. So the first really important question that I want you to ask yourself is, what can I do right now to start improving my situation? So if you feel like you've lost some momentum with your nutrition or with your fitness or both, like, what can I do right now to start improving my situation? So with your nutrition, obviously you can adjust to not eating out. I think that's a good thing. I think you're going to save a ton of money. I think you're going to eat much healthier. I think this will actually have a positive impact on the health across the country. And I know, like, I'm in a college town. There's a ton of locally owned restaurants and people are really making the push. Like, you got to, you know, support them. And I believe in that, but I know a lot of people out there were used to eating out almost every single day, and you can still support your local. Maybe you order out and get something, a healthier choice, once per week or twice per week instead of every day, and you're going to get a lot healthier. You're going to, you know, save quite a bit of money as well. So you're going to adjust to not eating out, and you have to set up your grocery and meal prep. Like, groceries are open still at this point, which I don't see those not being open unless the government expects us to start growing our own food. Although I'm handy with my shotgun, I can get out and acquire some venison here and again. So that could happen, but I don't think it'll come to that. But adjusting your obviously what's safe is if you can go once per week, once every 2 weeks. You know, with all the rules that are in place now. Like, I shop at Aldi, and they're like, okay, you can only buy four of each of these certain items, so that you can't hoard everything. So there's some to go around for everybody. So I think we get away once per week for sure. Once every 14 days to the grocery. So start mapping that out and map it out with a meal prep schedule. We're at home now. Like, meal prep should not be an issue because the whole work situation isn't, you know, you're not traveling. You're not like, I'm at my job all day. I don't have any time to meal prep. Well, if you're working from home or if you're out of work, get your meal prep game strong. All right. Like, whether you have a day or every other day, you prep for a couple of days. You know, I'm a big fan of the crock pot, but get in a flow, get in a rhythm with your meal prep. And when you are grocery shopping, don't bring crap into the house. If you know that you're going to sit around, if it's just a ticking time bomb to have, you know, cookies or soda or whatever sitting around, don't have it around. Your kids will get over it. Your spouse will get over it. All right. This is about health. And an extra motivator, look at all the people that are being impacted by the coronavirus, the ones that have those, you know, underlying health factors that are causing them to die from this. Like, that should be motivational. Like, don't get diabetes, don't have heart disease, don't be obese, because these are the issues. These are people that are getting killed by the virus. All right. So this should be extra motivation to eat healthy. Do not put yourself at a health disadvantage by eating crap during this whole quarantine situation. All right. So with our fitness, this is where a lot of people will get kind of depressed and they will quit taking action altogether because it's not perfect. They're going to wait for that perfect situation, but you got to do what you get. Whatever you got access to, you've got to work with it. So that's the first thing, is we have to figure out what you do have access to. At a minimum, you have access to your body weight and space, and we can get it done. I've helped people lose 100 pounds plus, with just body weight and space. It can be done. And they're strong, they're healthy. Again, it's not ideal. It's not perfect. It's not what you're used to, but it's what you have right now. Maybe you have some bands, maybe you have some dumbbells, kettlebells. I've got the pimped out podcast bunker. You know, I've got everything I need. I don't work out anywhere else. I always work out in my basement. So I've got everything I need with my squat rack, my Texas power bar. I've got 1,000 pounds of weights. I've got dumbbells from 10 pounds to 90 pounds. I've got an infrared sauna, shout out Sunlight and Sauna. The Bulletproof Vibe Plate. I got everything I need and I'm lucky. But that's already what I prefer. But I know a lot of you are relying on gyms and trainers and classes and things like that. So you've just got to get your mind right and say, all right, I can't be at my best right now with that. I'm not optimized, but I can still do my best. What does that look like? What do I have access to? All right. And at a minimum, you've got that body weight and space, and you can acquire resources and programs. I'm going to post in the show notes. I've got some resources that I do earn income off of. Like, that's something I want to address it with a quick aside. I've been getting a little bit of heat from some other people. Like, how can you sell online programs? You should be giving these away to everybody. And I've got, you guys out there that listen to me every week and know me, that are in my free community, that I'm giving my time away for free hours every week. Like, you know, I put all kinds of free resources out there. But if you want to level up, like, this is how I earn my money. And if you guys have an ability to work from home, then work from home. And this is me working from home by saying I've got some great follow along video, nutrition and fitness programs, mobility programs that you can do. I'm not going to jack up the prices and I'm not going to price gouge in this situation. I've actually put everything on discount to make it super affordable, but this will help me, keep things going. This helps me pay for my website and keep, buy food for my family. Like, this is how I pay the bills. I've got online coaching options. That's something that I haven't talked about a lot on the show. I'm putting that out there now. I've opened up more spots for one-on-one online coaching, working together. But anyway, I just wanted to say that, like, I don't feel bad about offering these things for a very, high value price. And if you guys have an issue with that at this time, then, maybe hit unsubscribe. I don't know. Hopefully you don't, but that's just me being honest. Like, this is, I've got lots of free resources out there as well. That free community that I talked about, right now, week one is accountability sprint week. Just go to millionpoundmission.com. and sign up for the Mission Possible community. All that's yours, free. Boom, go get it. But the other resources that are for monies will be in the show notes. Check it out. All right, so that's important question number one. What can I do right now to start improving my situation? Important question number two. What part of this whole thing is out of my control? All right, so let's look at some examples of this. I think this might be the most important question. What is out of my control? And we can't worry about what is out of our control, right? That's the whole point of this question. So all the craziness that's happening in the world, all the stress, all the fear-based news reporting, all that is out of our control. Something that I've been doing this week is I'm actually doing a CNN and news detox, where I was just finding myself checking it every hour, like, what happened now? What happened now? What happened now? And I have completely gone zero news. I do 10 minutes of news per day. And I love this resource. I'll give a shameless plug out to my friend Erica Mandy. She's got a podcast called The Newsworthy. She's no BS. She's positive. She doesn't do the fear thing. She's unbiased. It's 10 minutes or less. I listen to it on 1.5 speed, so it's like 7 minutes for me, but she's awesome, and she doesn't do the fear thing. She'll give you what you need to know quick and fast, fair, and easy, and that's all I do. 10 minutes in the morning, I know that she'll hook me up with what I need to know. Cool, good to go, boom, move on with my day, and I don't check the news the entire rest of the day. It's working for me. I'm sleeping better. My stress levels are down. I'm able to have higher quality sleep and meditation time, able to focus on working and producing content for you guys. All of that is much improved since I've done my CNN was my app of choice. So I'm doing my CNN detox. We can't control other people. Maybe you've got family members out there that aren't sticking to, advised regulations of staying at home. Maybe you're worried about other people being sick. Maybe you're all this stuff. Like, if you can't get out and get to them, you can care for them and talk to them with FaceTime and all that. But we can't control what other people are doing and the choices that they're making. So we have to let that go a little bit. And just other people's stress and reactions. Like, we can't control that. Like, how your friends and family members are going to react to this. Maybe they're really freaking out. You can offer to console them, to support them, but you can't figure it out for them. Like, they are going to do what they're going to do. So we have to let that go a little bit. So that's the important question number two. What part is out of my control? What are we stressing out about that's out of our control that we need to let go of? All right. You probably see what's coming next. Important question number three. What part of this is in my control? Again, very, very important. So things like your mindset, your nutrition, your fitness, your household. Like, what's happening inside your walls? You can control that for the most part. I know there are other people that exist in those walls, and you can't totally control that. But just things like, if you're stressed out about money, then really rein in and get frugal with your bills. Like, you guys know I love to nerd out about things like how I have a strategy where I open certain windows in my house during certain times of the day, so the house like heats itself, so I don't have to, you know, have a huge electric bill and all this stuff. Like, I nerd out about that. The use of fans strategically. I just got a bunch of free LED light bulbs from my electric company. I worked a deal out with them. So we can control things like that. If that's part of the stress that you're feeling is the financial stress, you know, what are we going to do about it? And that's really brings us to important question number four is, what can I learn or take away from this experience to create a positive, just create some positive momentum moving forward? It's like when we lift weights, we break down the muscle tissue, build it back stronger. Right now, we're all breaking down that life muscle tissue. And if we really think about things in the correct way and we don't let this whole thing take us down, we can come back stronger. Let that sink in a little bit. All right. So right now it's like we're all in leg day and we aren't going to be able to walk right for a while. It's going to be super sore from this, but eventually we come back stronger together. All right. So things to think about. I think people will learn how much healthier they will be from eating at home instead of eating at restaurants. I think that's going to be a huge realization. Again, you know, and maybe restaurants will adjust and say, we need healthier options, or we need to be more price effective. That's another thing. People are going to save a ton of money. Like, how much money you save from not eating out. If I take my family out to eat versus eating at home, it is 5 to 10 times more expensive every time, guaranteed. 5 to 10 times. And if you do that multiple times per week, you are like doubling, tripling, quadrupling your food budget every single month. Is that worth it? You know, if you're feeling financial stress right now, you know, what adjustments are you going to make moving forward? All right. So I think that's another thing, is just the financial resilience. Something that I take a lot of heart in, and again, that something I love to nerd out on, is that I always keep an 18-month emergency fund in a high-yield savings account that is not tied to the stock market. So this is kind of the best-case scenario for that. Not, I hate to call it a best-case scenario, but this is the exact precise scenario why I have that, is if the stock market takes a tumble and I'm not able to earn money like normal, then is there an area to live off of, a fund to live off of? And that's my emergency fund. I use Ally, ALLY.com, just high yield savings account. Doesn't earn a ton of interest, but I have 18 months worth of our family's bills in there at all times so that I can live off of that. And that is exactly what I'm doing right now. I'm feeding my kids with that. I know a lot of people, and maybe some of you out there, are stressed because you're not getting your next paycheck. And that's a problem. That's an issue where if you're spending everything that you got, everything that comes in is going out, that's a problem. And that's something that you can really start adjusting your life now and your lifestyle. If you're eating out 5 times a week and you have zero emergency fund right now, that's a problem. And right now you're feeling that scar tissue build up because of that problem. And you can fix it and come out better the other end of this. All right, so I expect some of you to start building up some emergency funds. Let's see what else. We've got people are going to realize how to use tech a lot better. Like, my parents are learning how to use Zoom, and they're in their 60s and 70s. So we're going to learn how to communicate with people all over the world with technology. So once we can actually connect with people in person, we can still, if we don't see them as often as we'd like to, we can leverage technology. I think a lot of people will learn that. I think people really learn to appreciate the ability to connect in person. That personal trainer, you're not going to take them for granted. That coach, that community that you take group fitness classes with, you know, the people you walk with on walking Wednesday at work, the people that you work with, you know, just getting out of the house and be able to interact, giving hugs, giving high fives. I think high fives and fist bumps are really going to be going nuts across the world once we can actually do that again. People will just be ready to interact. And I think the friendly factor will really jump up as well. I think people really are going to bond. You know, some people are like, oh my God, my whole family's under one house. We all we do is you know, talk to each other. You know, I don't see that as a bad thing. Like, I'm really enjoying this time. I get my kids all day long, every day. I don't see that as a minus. I see that as a plus. And use that time to bond. I think moving forward, we're all going to feel more connected. So just some things to think about, like, what can you learn or take away? Like, where are the pain points you're feeling right now with your health, with your finances? If you're somebody that is in one of the high risk groups because of your health, what are you going to do about it? If you're at a high risk group because of your finances, what are you going to do about it? Now is the time to sit and think and map that out and take action in line with that, instead of just hoping for the best. Like, oh, hope everything goes back to normal. You know, I have one paycheck and then we're screwed. Like, don't put yourself in that position again. All right. Don't put yourself at risk just because you like to drink soda every day and now you've got diabetes. Like, let's fix these things, because this won't be the last pandemic that happens, you know, most likely in our lifetime. Like, these things will start to pop up just because of the way the world is. Right. And hopefully next time we're just a little bit more prepared for it. So, I think that's good for this chat today. Again, if you want to dive into the community, just go to millionpoundmission.com and dive into those free resources. Join the Mission Possible community. It's the top of the page. It's a great resource. That's we do the challenge week, we do the accountability sprint week, you know, the hot seats, all that stuff. And it's kind of dispersed, but the command center is when you go to millionpoundmission.com and you opt in to the free community. That gives you all the links to all the resources, that gets you all the organization tools so that you can fully participate into everything. All right. So go there, get it. If you want to look at any of my online fitness programs, let's say I put up my Accelerate 28 program, in the show notes. That is a follow along daily body weight and mobility. So 10 minutes body weight exercise, 10 minutes mobility, follow along videos, just push play. We take care of the rest. I've got a clean eating meal plan with that as well. I've got my Hello Abs Bootcamp in there. That is a daily follow along workout, abdominal focused, that has my craving crusher meal plan. And then I've got a link for one-on-one coaching. So if you want really more customized advice, daily access to me, interaction on a weekly basis with video chats, one-on-one, that is in there as well. And again, I'm here to support you. You can email me, you can hit me up on Instagram at Million Pound Mission with questions. If there's any way I can support you through this, just let me know. And I know some of you guys are out there, you are purchasing my stuff. I just want to say, I appreciate that. Like, that's paying my bills right now, and that's huge. So, if it makes sense, let's do that. Otherwise, I'll support you however I can. I'll keep adding energy in your direction, and we're going to get out there together and own it every meal, every workout, every day. I will see you on the next episode. Thank you so much for listening to this week's episode. Now, don't forget to head on over to millionpoundmission.com to pick up your free Mission Possible Community Virtual Welcome Kit. Now, this free resource is going to show you how to get plugged into our community chats, our amazing Facebook group. It'll show you how to sign up for one-on-one hot seat sessions with me, the PhD, and we'll even show you how to start your own local meetup group for that extra support. Now, remember, my friend, this isn't just a podcast. This is a community, and you are an important part of it. So head on over to millionpoundmission.com today and get plugged in.